In this lecture, we will talk about the changes that might occur to the lease arrangement after the commencement date. There are two categories for these changes. The first category is the change in the original lease terms and conditions, and this change is known as a lease modification. A lease modification arises when both the lessee and the lessor renegotiate the original terms and conditions of the lease. This modification involves increasing or decreasing the scope of the lease, or any other modification that is neither an increase or decrease in the scope of the lease, like, for example, changing the consideration for the lease arrangement. The second category of the changes that might occur to the lease after the commencement date is the change in the estimates and the assessments on which the lease payments are based. This category of changes do not modify the terms and conditions of the original contract. Examples of these changes include changes in the assessment of the length of the lease term, or changes in the amounts expected to be payable under residual value guarantee, or changes in the assessment of an option to purchase the underlying asset, or changes in the rates and indices on which the future lease payments are based. So, let us see how to account for both categories of changes. We will start first with the accounting for lease modifications. Accounting for lease modifications involves accounting for the modification either as a new separate lease, or accounting for the modification by adjusting the original lease. That accounting depends on whether the modification is an increase or decrease in the scope of the lease, or is any other modification that is neither an increase nor decrease in the scope. A lease modification should be accounted for as a new separate lease if both of the following conditions are met. First, the modification increases the scope of the lease, and that increase should be by adding the right to use one or more underlying assets. An example of this is when the modification increases the number of leased vehicles from 10 to 15 vehicles. A modification that increases the scope of the lease by changing any other term rather than adding a right to use an additional asset is not accounted for as a separate lease. For example, a modification that increases the scope of the lease by extending the contractual lease term is not accounted for as a separate lease. The second condition that should be met to account for the modification as a separate lease is that the consideration for the lease increases by an amount commensurate with the standalone prices for that increase in scope, adjusted to reflect the circumstances of the contract. If both conditions are satisfied, then the lessee should account for the modification as a new separate lease transaction. The accounting for the original lease is not changed. If one of the conditions is not met, then the lease modification is not accounted for as a separate lease. Instead, the lessee should adjust the original lease for that modification. In other words, you should adjust the right of use asset and the lease liability of the original lease. Here, the lease liability should be recalculated as of the effective date of modification, the date on which the modified contract was signed. To do that, you should do the following. Determine the consideration and the lease term of the modified lease contract. Then, revise the lease payments. Then, recalculate the lease liability by discounting the revised lease payments to the modification date using the revised discount rate. This revised rate is determined as the interest rate implicit in the lease for the remainder of the lease term, if that rate can be readily determined, or the lessee's incremental borrowing rate at the effective date of the modification, if the interest rate implicit in the lease cannot be readily determined. On the other hand, the adjustment to the right of use asset depends on the nature of the modification on hand. If the modification involves a decrease in the scope of the lease, like, for example, modifications that involve reducing the leased space, or reducing the number of leased vehicles, or reducing the lease term of the lease, this means that we have a partial, or full termination of the original lease. In this case, you should calculate the reduction in the carrying amount of the right-of-use asset, in proportion to the decrease in the scope of the lease, to reflect that partial or full termination of lease. Then, recognize in the profit and loss, the gain or loss resulting from the partial or full termination of the lease. For any other modifications, like for example, modifications that change the consideration of the lease, or that increase the scope of the lease but without adding a right to use an additional asset, or that increase the scope of the lease without a commensurate increase in the consideration, here we need only to make a corresponding adjustment to the right of use asset, in the same amount of the adjustment done to the lease liability. Now, let us illustrate with few examples in the following lecture.